I said, take a little knee to give effort. You have to run a 4.440 to give effort. But you have to vertical jump in here 39 inches to give effort. No, it's not a God-given thing. It's a choice. It's your character. It's your attitude. It's your thoughts, your habits, your priorities. To make a choice that I'm going to finish this, I'm going to do it, I'm going to play fast, I'm going to play hard. That's your choice. We're going to evaluate that. And we're going to say finish. And we're going to demand that you finish what you do. The second thing is in football, guys, football is not a game for everything. And I have a tremendous amount of respect for every guy that's here because you play the game. It's a great team game, and it's not for everybody. But there's something else that it takes. It takes mental and physical toughness to play this game. Now, we're not going to challenge it physically here. We don't even have pads on. But the mental part, mental toughness part, comes in your ability to sustain what you're supposed to do and have the discipline to sustain it. Because we're going to go through 3 days of practice, and maybe you go out there the first day and it's easy, but the second day you're a little sore and tired. Can you do it the next day? That's mental. You make the choice. Mental toughness. Because people who have mental toughness can deliver in the difficult times in the game. And they don't get distracted by external factors in the game, like the scoreboard. Should it affect how you play in the game, whether you're 20 points ahead or 20 points behind? Absolutely not. If you're trying to dominate the guy you're playing against, and you're a great competitor, that scoreboard doesn't determine how you play. You determine how you play by who you are. And that's important. That's important. And that's comes from having mental toughness. And the third thing, guys, is everybody here is going to have to focus and be responsible for their own self-determination. What's that mean? What's your job? What am I supposed to do? What's my responsibility here? Whether it's an air Bama ball at night, or cover three, or as a receiver, as a DB, whatever it is, be responsible for what you're supposed to do. What time you're supposed to be in at night? Now, there's one prerequisite for that, guys. If you're not in very good shape, you're not going to be able to do any three of those things. And when you go back to your high school, you better know that it takes physical conditioning to be able to sustain these things. Because when are you going to load? When you're tired. Fatigue makes cowards of us all. Vince Lombardi said that. So when you get tired, you're not going to be as tough. And when are you not going to be responsible to do your job and make mental errors in the game? When you're tired. So you got to be in great shape. That's the way it is. Now there's one more thing I want to talk to you guys about. There's nothing that I don't respect more than a guy that's a great competitor. Now what makes a great competitor? If you're a great competitor and you think about the best player you've ever played against, one of the things that guy had to do when you played against him was you thought you couldn't beat him by his body language and how he presented himself to you and how he competed against you. Is that right or wrong? His presence. So, when you go out there and you're a competitor, if you're bending over when you get tired, if your body language says I'm tired, if your body language says I'm beat, if your body language says I can't do it, what are you telling the other guy you're playing against? Beat me now. Beat me now. I'm going to tell you one more story about that and I'm going to close. There was a friend of mine named Joe Lipson. How many of you guys know who Marvin Hagler is? Heard of Marvin Hagler? He's a middleweight champion of the world for probably the last 10 or 12 years. He's probably out of it for 2 years now, but for a long time he dominated his sport as a middleweight boxer. I mean, as good as middleweight as Muhammad Ali was as a heavyweight. My buddy's 30-0. He's going to go fight Marvin Hagler. This is in 1997 for the middleweight championship of the world. He's 17-1 underdog. 17-1. Got no chance to win. Everybody gives him no chance. Commentators give him no chance, fans give him no chance, gamblers, bettors give him no chance, he's 17-1. So he goes in the fight, he wins the first round. He wins the second round. He wins the third round. against the champion of the world, and Marvin Hagler for 7 or 8 years had been a champion at that time. My buddy beats him in 3 rounds. My buddy was 30-0 going into the fight. In the 4th round, Marvin Hagler damn near killed my buddy. Had to go to the hospital, ended his career, had a concussion, all kinds of stuff. TKO'd him, beat him to death. So I asked my buddy once, I said, it's about 2 months later, I said, how could you do so well in a fight in 3 rounds, and then in the 4th round, just get killed like that? What happened? And I thought he was going to say, Marvin Hagler hit me and hurt me and I couldn't defend myself. And you know what he said? He said, I hit him with my best shot at the end of the 3rd round, and it never fazed me. And I never thought I had a chance to win after that. So what's that said? How did Marvin Hagler win this fight? He won the fight because of his mental toughness and his competitive spirit of how he took the guy's best shot. So when you're out there playing and a guy whips you on a play and you show him that he whipped you, what do you tell him? Come whip me some more. When you take his best shot and it doesn't faze you, and you get up and you get off the ground and you go back to the huddle and you line up the next time and you're ready to play, what are you telling the guy? Eventually, what's the guy say? This guy's taking my best shot, and I'm not whipping him at all. And eventually, what are you going to do? Whip him. And whose choice is that? It's yours. It's yours. Is that right? And when you do that, that's what makes a great competitor. And you will affect every guy on your team if you can do that. Now, look, guys, we want you to have fun at this camp. Let me tell you what the fun of this camp is. You know, everybody says have fun. What's fun of playing? What's the fun of playing? Winning.